Hello people of YouTube, Pixie here, and today on my channel we are doing a tea talk, and guess what? It's not on Tuesday anymore. I decided that I'm going to keep the general topics of my videos, but there will be no more alliterations with my channel, so there will still be tea talk videos. They just will no longer, they might be on Tuesday possibly randomly, but it'll be by a coincidence. It will not be because it is tea talk Tuesday. I will just make tea talks whenever I feel like, and today is like the absolute perfect day to do a tea talk because it is National Tea Day, and I'm like, how did I not hear about this until literally actually the day? I saw it trending on Twitter and I was like, this was made for me. And because it is National Tea Day, I made a cup of tea. It is English breakfast tea, which is like my absolute all-time favorite morning tea. And so today we are going to be doing a Q&A, or we are going to be doing a tag. It is the tea tag in honor of National Tea Day. So I have the questions on my phone, so I apologize if I'm looking down too much, but let's go ahead and get on into this video. Okay, question number one, hot or cold? Okay, so generally I would say hot. I think I like hot more, just because I feel like I drink hot tea more often. However, I have been recently, especially because it is getting warmer outside, spring is, you know, here, spring is upon us, I have been getting more into colder teas. I just generally always like warm teas or hot teas better though, just because something about that like cozy feeling, and y'all already know I'm like a big fall lover, so I think that's why I like tend to lean towards hot rather than cold, but I do still appreciate cold teas. Strong or weak? Definitely strong. Like, I don't even know if that's even a question. Strong. I definitely like, I guess maybe if you're talking about like a subtle tea flavor, like if it's not too overpowering, but for like, for English breakfast, like morning teas and stuff like that, I like a strong, like, I can taste that tea. I don't want weak teas. Also, like, I tried to find a chai, like a hot chai, tea, and I like them strong. I don't like them weak. So yeah, I guess I would say strong. Loose leaf or tea bags? Okay, so I would say probably loose leaf, just because I find that the quality of the tea is like a little bit better. However, if I'm in a rush or something like that, then if it's already in a bag, that's like amazing. It's just quick and easy. So if I'm in a rush, then tea bags. However, and I do like the little ones that have little sayings on them. I think that's really cute too. So, but I would still say loose leaf is like a little bit better quality most of the time. Do you buy your tea? Do you buy your tea out or steep it at home? As you already know, I do steep my tea at home for the most part. However, days that I'm like working or days that I didn't have time to make tea in the morning, I will definitely get my tea fix somewhere else. So there are two places that I like to get my tea, or actually three. I guess I do drink tea outside of my house more than I think I do. So first place is Asha Tea House. Oh my god, you guys. I don't want to like overhype them, but it is really, really, really good. I really recommend you go. There's one in Berkeley and there's one in San Francisco, and I've been to both and they're both great. I normally just get like their basic, like, I think it's not like breakfast tea, but it's like their basic like milk tea. It is delicious. They use like this like syrupy honey, and they know what they're doing. Other places that I go to get my tea, I like Quickly a lot, if you're familiar with that, or Share Tea. I get a lot of my teas from Share Tea, especially because their menu is like so extensive. I get to try literally a new thing every time I'm there, so that's really always exciting. And the last place is of course Starbucks, because there's always a Starbucks nearby. And so for me, I normally get cold teas there. I don't really ever get hot teas there, just because their hot tea isn't really like they make, like it's just, you know, pre-packaged like in a little tea bag, which is fine, but I prefer like their cold teas better. So I always get like the mango black tea lemonade as like my go-to tea from Starbucks. Okay, next question. Favorite cold tea? Okay, I would definitely say my favorite cold tea is Thai tea. is like literally the best cold tea that there is probably, in my opinion. It's so good. And there used to be this place where I used to live that was like right down the street from my my co-op. It was so good. I miss it so much. All right, next question. Favorite hot tea? Definitely this one. Okay. Or if you're like going out, then definitely the one at Asha Tea House. But if we're just talking about me making my tea, it's definitely English breakfast tea is the best. I also do really like chamomile, but I have to say this is my favorite. Next question. When do you like to drink your tea? Literally all the time. I like making English breakfast in the morning if I know I need like a good dose of caffeine. I also like to drink it at night though. Like I like to have chamomile at night, like after I get home from work. I just like to chill out with some nice chamomile, some nice agave in that chamomile, and just like soothes me. So it really depends on like what I'm doing, but I pretty much drink tea all times of the day. Like I could be out and about and I would get like, yeah, Thai tea, some chai, I don't know. You know, there's a bunch of different things, but generally I drink them in the morning and the night, I guess. But pretty much always, like I always am drinking tea because it's so good. Next question. What do you like in your tea? Milk, cream, sugar, etc. Okay, so for me, I drink my tea with a lot of almond milk. Like for English breakfast, as you already saw, I add sugar, I add almond milk, and yeah. For chamomile, I like to add like, yeah, agave nectar. It is really, really good. I highly recommend it. Honey is also good too in chamomile, I feel, so that is also delicious. All right, next question. Have you always liked tea? Okay, this is a funny one, so this needs to like, actually I need to like literally put the tea down to tell you this story. Okay, so no, surprisingly, I have not always liked tea, which is like, I can't believe it myself, because I'm such a tea addict now, but I have not always liked tea. When I was a kid, I think I've already mentioned this, but I'm a quarter Japanese, so growing up, I would always have like green tea, like that was like the first tea I was ever introduced to, and I really didn't like it. Like I thought, ugh, like it has no taste. Like also I feel like a lot of the time whenever I would drink green tea with my family, we wouldn't really ever add sugar or anything like that, and I didn't really know like all of the things that you could do to tea, but if you know what I mean. So when I was a kid, I never really liked green tea. I didn't acquire a taste for it until I got older. And the reason that I got into tea is actually really silly. And it's because I started reading, have you ever seen that movie, Angus Thongs and Perfect Snogging? I got into that book series, or I saw the movie first, and then I realized that it was a book, and so I read the book, and it was like my favorite book, and I read like the entire series, and I thought I was like so cool drinking my chamomile, drinking this like British book series. So that's how I like got into tea. I also had like this friend who was from England, and we had like a tea party at my house, and that was like my first time where like we like actually went out and bought tea that wasn't like chamomile and it wasn't green tea, because we always had green tea in the house, but like I like went out and like picked out different teas because I knew this kid was gonna come over, and my friends were there. We had like a little tea party. That's a whole other story. Maybe I'll make a story time video about that. But anyway, so I started drinking tea, and he was like, oh, do you have milk for this tea? And I was like, oh yeah, I do. And I didn't ever know that you added milk to tea. This was in like high school. I think I was like a sophomore or freshman or something. I think I was a sophomore. So that was how I like discovered all the different teas, by meeting that friend and also by reading that book series. And so I highly recommend reading that book series if you want like a good laugh. And I thought it was a great series, and I just thought I was the coolest drinking my chamomile with my sugar or whatever I used to put in it, and reading this British book series. So yeah, I haven't always liked tea, but that's how I got into it more so. Okay. Number 10, what tea do you recommend? Okay, so I definitely have already given you all some recommendations, Asha Tea House, and if you're not obviously in the area, I think you can actually order I swear this isn't sponsored. Now that I'm like saying it, it sounds sponsored. Honestly, I wish it was. Like, Asha, if you're watching this, come sponsor your girl. Like, you know I love your tea. But no, it's not sponsored. But yeah, if you can, I think you can actually order that tea online. And also, I would recommend Thai tea to everybody, because I thought I wasn't gonna like it for some reason, but it is delicious, man. It is bomb.com. And also I would recommend just basic English breakfast tea. The one that I get is, actually it's gonna be in the next question. So extra question number 11, do you have a favorite brand of tea? So this like brand of tea that I'm drinking and I am obsessed with is from San Francisco Herb Company, I think is what it's called. Like, if I'm wrong, I will like link, or I will type it on the screen if it's wrong, but I'm pretty sure that's what it's called. You can go to, this also isn't sponsored, you can go to sfherb.com and you can order their teas, and I think they're pretty reasonably priced. I actually got introduced to that company, or that brand of tea, while living in the co-ops. Like, seriously, I'm so grateful, like, just living in the co-ops. If the only thing that I took away from the living in the co-ops was learning about this tea company, it was like money well spent. It is so good. I love this tea. Like, I love this tea where, oh my gosh, I can't even explain to you how much I love this tea, but I think you are understanding how much I love it just by how much I'm expressing that I love it, because I highly recommend it, and that's my favorite brand. They make literally any tea you can think of. I actually went not that long ago, like literally like last weekend, to restock on that tea, and they have like a little warehouse in San Francisco. So it was cool, but you can also buy all their teas online in like bulk and pretty decently priced and delicious, and yeah. But I would recommend them for sure. Okay, least favorite tea. Oh, I hate to do this. Like, do they mean least favorite tea, or like in general, like the taste of it, or do they mean least favorite tea as in like tea specifically from this one brand? Cause like I generally like chai, and I was trying to find a chai, and I went and I bought this chai at like, I don't know, I think I got this from Safeway. That sounds more right. So Safeway, I was trying to find a chai, and I ended up picking up this chai that people had like recommended. I'll link whatever its like specific brand is. I think they actually, their company makes other teas that are actually like really good. Just, I feel like this one didn't do it for me, like in the flavor profile. It wasn't as strong as I had hoped it was. Like, it was really subtle chai, and I was like, oh, I was really hoping this was gonna be like a punch you in the face chai, but it wasn't. It was really, really like, I don't know, I didn't like it, but it was so highly recommended. So I don't know, I'll link it like right here, whatever exact brand it was, because like I know they make a couple chais, but this one in particular, it didn't do it for me, but I really wish it did. And if anyone has any chai recommendations, please, please give your girl some info in the comment section below, okay? Still on the hunt for some good chai that I can just like pop, like that I can make at home, basically. Okay, is there a particular snack you like to eat with your tea? Yes, I would say that I like to, I guess, eat it with, or drink my tea with breakfast. It's not really a snack, but kind of like, well, do you know Morningstar sausage patties? I'll make those like every morning with my tea, or like I'll make like a little English muffin with my tea. Those are really good. Okay, last question. What is your favorite mug? Okay, so this is a hard one, and I actually don't think I have an answer for this, just because I don't think I can pick a favorite. Generally, what I like to do is, I have like a crazy, huge, extensive tea mug collection, or coffee cup, whatever you want to call them, mug collection. So it's really hard to say which is my favorite. What I like to do is buy them like for whatever season I'm in. For example, it's spring now, so I've got like this yellow one with like kind of like floral designs on it. And then for Christmas time or the holiday time, I have, you know, like my Christmas mug, a few Christmas mugs. And then for Halloween, like, which is my all-time favorite holiday, I have a pumpkin mug, which I got. And so I've just been kind of like adding to the collection. I've got like a rainy day mug, got a pink Valentine's Day mug. Literally, I'm all about like showing holiday spirit, whatever holiday it is. And so I just have like tea mugs for the different seasons and holidays. I'll do like a mug collection. That might be a good video just because I have so many. I feel like I might have listed them all off, but I've got a lot of cool mugs. I really don't think I can pick a favorite, so who knows? I'm just a big holiday lover, and yeah. So that is the tea tag. I hope you all enjoyed it. And yeah, leave me comments below what you thought. What are your favorite teas? What are your least favorite teas? All that good stuff. If you aren't subscribed to this channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Please join our little teacup family. I think that's what I might call y'all. I don't know. Still a work in progress with that one. But anyway, yeah, I will see you all in my next video.